So friends, welcome back to the class. So again, we are continuing the remaining topic in potentiometry. So now, in this video, we are going to discuss about gas electrodes. So in this, the first electrode is hydrogen electrode. The first electrode is hydrogen electrode. So friends, this is the representation of hydrogen electrode. So what is hydrogen electrode? So friends, here, so we are dipping, this is a platinum electrode or a platinum wire. We are dipping into one acidic solution. Generally, that acidic solution is hydrochloric acid. So now this is used as a standard hydrogen electrode. So friends, so hydrogen gas is bubbled a solution of acid, and this electrode is going to form some electrochemical reaction. That electrochemical reaction is, so whatever the acidic solution is there, that acidic solution generally we are going to take in aqueous medium. So now the hydrogen ion taking the electron, after taking the electron, the hydrogen ion converted into hydrogen gas, half mole of hydrogen gas. So this hydrogen gas is comes out from the hydrogen electrode. So these are the bubbles which are coming out as hydrogen gas. So this hydrogen electrode can be represented as, so hydrogen electrode are represented as this representation of hydrogen. So this is going to represent it like platinum, so H2 so gas, and this is dipped into the H plus ion solution, that is acidic solution. So friends, here the electrode potential of hydrogen electrode potential. So from the above equation, so we are going to measure electrode potential of the hydrogen electrode is equal to E naught minus 0.0592 by only one electron is transferring, that's why by one into log of 1 by concentration of H plus ions. Concentration of H plus ions. This is equal to standard potential of hydrogen electrode is equal to 0 minus 0.0592 into log of 1 by concentration of H plus ions. So here, this is simply we are going to write as 0.0592 into pH. Sir, why we are writing as pH? Because, so the reason is, so pH is equal to minus of log of H plus ions, concentration of H plus ions. So here, that's why, so E is equal to written as 0.0592 into pH. Sir, idu ela vachindanante, ikkada chudandi. So what is that log of 1 by concentration of H plus ions are there. So this is equal to, can be written minus of log minus H plus ions, minus of minus H plus ions. So now, so what is pH? pH is equal to minus log H plus. So in place of this complete term, we are going to write minus log H plus. So here we have the one minus, that minus we are writing like this. So E is equal to minus 0.0592 into pH. So now, What are the merits of hydrogen electrode? So now we are going to discuss about merits of hydrogen electrode. So friends, this is the first electrode, the first reference electrode, which is used to measure the potential of other electrodes. So this is the starting electrode used as a reference electrode to find the potential of other electrodes. Second one, it can be used entire pH range. So you can use this electrode from 0 to 14 pH, entire pH range. So third one is, so now third one. So you see friends, whenever you dip the electrode into standard acidic solution, standard acidic solution. So when you dip the electrode into standard acidic solution, then it will work as a reference electrode. Otherwise, whenever you dip the electrode into the same solution, which solution concentration is does not known to us, then it will act as a indicator electrode. So friends, here the hydrogen electrode can be used as a reference as well as indicator electrode. So how it is using as a reference electrode? When you dip it into the standard acidic solution, that is a reference electrode. The same electrode, when you dip it into the same solution whose concentration is unknown to us, then it will work as a indicator electrode. So next, demerits of hydrogen electrode. Demerits of hydrogen electrode. So what are the demerits? So now here friends, factors like purity of hydrogen and the pressure of hydrogen going to affect potential of its electrode. So purity of hydrogen as well as the pressure of hydrogen. So hydrogen pressure you must maintain as 1 atma pressure. 1 atma pressure. This is going to affect so the potential of electrode. Second demerit is, so it can be affected by oxidizing and reducing substances. So the hydrogen electrode can be affected by oxidizing and reducing electrode. Third demerit is, the potential may be affected due to poisoning of platinum surface. So this platinum surface can be undergo some reactions. That's why, so due to poisoning of this platinum surface, the potential can be affected. So these are the demerits of hydrogen electrode. So next one is a metal dipped into the metal solution, that is called a metal. So what is the type now? The type is metal dipped into the metal ionic solution. Metal dipped into the metal ionic solution. So in this case, the example is a calomel electrode. Calomel electrode. So friends, so in our laboratory we use this calomel electrode now. So here you can see this. This is the general block diagram of calomel electrode. So here it is a Hg, mercury liquid. So here we are using mercurous chloride. Mercurous chloride, and around this we are using saturated KCl solution. And here we have a some dip. So this complete is called standard calomel electrode. You can see this. This complete solution is KCl solution. Here at bottom you can observe these droplets are Hg2Cl2. Along with that, mercury is there. So this mixture is called calomel. So this calomel is again connected with the platinum wire, and this finally this platinum wire again dipped into here. This is a mercury. So this electrode is called calomel electrode.
So friends, what is the description of calomel electrode? How you are going to represent the calomel electrode description? The calomel electrode represented like this. Mercury, yes, that mercury dipped into the mercurous chloride, Hg2Cl2. So now this is again having, so which solution? KCl solution. Solution. This is the electrode representation, calomel electrode representation. So most probably used laboratory electrode is calomel electrode. So now, okay, <friend. coughs> okay, friends. How we? So sorry. So here, how we are going to establish this mercuric electrode? So now in this case, at the bottom of a tube, at the bottom of tube, we are using mercury. At the bottom of tube, we are using mercury. Here we are at bottom of the tube, we are using the mercury, and here the mercury is covered by, so this mercury is covered by, this mercury now covered by yes, right, mercurous chloride. The mercury is covered by mercurous chloride, so that is Hg2Cl2. So you can observe that, so Hg2Cl2 is covering the mercury. So this complete mixture Hg2Cl2 is called calomel. It is called a calomel here. So now here above this we are going to use, above this paste we are going to use a solution of KCl. So above this paste we are using a solution of KCl. So now the concentration of KCl can be decinormal, normal, or any other else. So here the KCl concentration can be decinormal or normal or any other So now, so friends, first how we are establishing calomel electrode. We are taking a tube. In this tube, at bottom of the tube, we are keeping mercury. On that top, on the above of mercury, we are keeping a paste, mercurous chloride. This mercurous chloride paste has covered by, so again, KCl solution. The KCl solution concentration may be decinormal, normal, or any other. So friends, here Hg plus 2 ions sparingly soluble. So whatever the Hg2 plus ions are there, these Hg2 plus ions are sparingly soluble, and these can be discharged at cathode. So now, so whatever, yes. So here whatever Hg2 plus 2 ions, mercurous ions, these are sparingly soluble. So these are sparingly, that means partially soluble, sparingly soluble. So that's why these can be discharged. So the Hg2 plus ions can be discharged at a cathodic electrode. At which electrode? Cathode electrode. So friends, so now here the result of increasing concentration of chlorides. The result of increasing, so now this is going to increase concentration of chloride ions. Why? Because here what we are taking, Hg2 2 plus ions plus 2 chlorides are there. when these mercurous ions are going to be discharged to mercury, now the concentrations of chloride ion will be increasing. The concentration of chloride ion is going to be increased. That's why the reaction can be written like this. The reaction can be written like this. So here we are going to write the reaction. So now you see that whatever the mercury is there, that mercurous ions, these mercurous ions are taking the two electrons and these are converting into mercury, two moles of mercury in liquid form. So now these are Hg2Cl2. So again, this Hg2Cl2 again converting into, yes, again converting into Hg2 plus 2 Cl minus ions. That's why, friends, what they are saying. So now the electrode is involving in oxidation. So now this is going to liberate the electrons. So now these electrons are sent to Hg2 plus ions into the solution. So now these can be combined with the chloride ions. So then they can be going to form mercurous chloride. So friends, so again, what they are saying. So here the mercury, whatever present here, this is going to, so here at this, so whatever the mercury is there, this mercury, yes, can convert into, this mercury can convert into mercurous ion. These mercurous ions again combined with chloride ions, whatever increased during the discharge of mercurous ions, now these are going to combine with chloride ions and again these are forming Hg2Cl2. So these are forming Hg2Cl2, an aqueous solution. So that's why, so this equation completely represented like this. So now you see this, the equation completely represented like this. So now Hg2Cl2, so this is a solid we are taking. So now this is taking two electrons. After taking the two electrons, so this will convert into two moles of Hg. So this Hg is a liquid. So now two chloride ions are remained in aqueous solution. So that's why here what they are saying, friends, these are going to say that right up here the calomel electrode is a reversible electrode. Calomel electrode is reversible electrode. And it will be, so depends on, that means the potential of calomel electrode depends on potential of calomel. So potential of calomel electrode depends on right here two points. So here the potential of calomel electrode depends on two points. The first one is concentration of KCl used. Second one, the temperature whatever you are maintaining. So now, so based on these two, the potential of electrode will depends. So now we are going to discuss about the merits of calomel electrode. What are the merits of calomel electrode? So friends, here two merits are per calomel electrode. So those are, so now it is a very easy to construction, very easy to construction. So simple method to construct the metacalomel electrode. Second one, stability of potential. Second merit is stability of potential. So friends, this is a calomel electrode. So friends, next we are going to discuss about twin hydrogen electrode. So here this twin hydrogen electrode is a oxidation reduction type electrode. Oxidation and reduction type electrode. Oxidation and the reduction type electrode. So twin hydrogen electrode is a oxidation and the reduction electrode. So now here this is going to consist, this is consist a platinum wire. So the twin hydrogen electrode is going to consist a platinum wire. So this is dipped into the solution containing the platinum wire, dipped into a solution, into a solution. Now this solution is going to have twin hydrogen and quinone molecules. So this solution going to have twin hydrogen and quinone molecules. Twin hydrogen and the quinone molecules. So these are present in equimolar concentration. So friends, twin hydrogen electrode is a type of oxidative and reductive electrode. So this is the consist of platinum wire. So now the platinum wire dipped into the solution. This is the solution of twin hydrogen and quinone molecules. These are present in equimoles. So what is the electrode reaction? What is the electrode reaction? You see, the reaction is, so now here I am taking twin hydrogen. So this is the structure of twin hydrogen. This twin hydrogen is taking two electrons and two protons, two electrons and two protons. Then it is converted into hydroquinone. This will convert into hydroquinone. So this is the reaction. So going to take place in twin hydrogen electrodes. So the electrode can be represented like this. The representation of twin hydrogen electrode. Representation. So representation of twin hydrogen electrode. That is, obviously we are dipping a platinum electrode. So the platinum wire into QQH2. So this consists of acidic solution H plus ions in aqueous medium. So this is the representation of twin hydrogen electrode. So friends, this is about twin hydrogen electrode. Now, so we are going to discuss another important topic, that is glass electrode. So this is the representation, block diagram of glass electrode. So the block glass electrode is going to consist of so obviously a silver in silver chloride. So that's why it is a silver chloride electrode. So now this glass electrode generally used as indicator electrode. Glass electrode generally used as indicator electrode. It is generally used for indicator electrode. So here it is a selective and responsive to change in concentration of hydrogen ion. So now friends, this is a selective and responsive. This electrode is a selective and responsive. So towards change in concentration of hydrogen ion. Change in concentration of hydrogen ion. So here glass electrode is a indicator electrode. It is a selective and responsive towards so responsive towards change in hydrogen electrode. So friends, so as you seen in the diagram, this electrode consists of a glass tube. This electrode consists of a glass tube. The electrode consists of a glass tube with pH sensitive glass bulb. So with the pH sensitive glass bulb. pH sensitive glass bulb. You can see here. So pH sensitive glass bulb. This one. So friends, here, right here. Sorry. So here you see that the glass electrode is going to consist a glass tube with the pH sensitive glass bulb. Okay, so here a silver chloride wire is present at the center of the tube. So this one is silver chloride bulb present at the center of the tube. So now the lower tip so immerse into 0.1 concentration HCl solution. 0.1 m concentration HCl solution. So now this complete assemble worked as an indicator electrode. So this complete assemble worked as a indicator electrode. So friends, the combined it worked as a indicator electrode. So friends, so most of the cases in pH meter, so we are going to use this glass bulb electrode. So now the potential of this electrode can be so seen like this. So now here E is equal to K plus 0.0592 into pH 1 minus pH 2 at 25 degrees centigrade. So like this you are going to determine the potential of the electrode. What is K here? So let us going to write what is K. And what is pH 1 and what is pH 2? So here friends, the K is equal to constant for the electrode. It is a constant for electrode. The pH 1 is equal to the pH of the solution inside the bulb. So pH of the solution. So inside the bulb. So what is pH 2? pH of the solution. So at the outside, nothing but the test solution pH. So friends, so this is the equation to use determine the pH of the electrode. So friends, what are the advantages of glass electrode? So here, this will show a rapid response towards change in concentration of H plus ions. This is going to show a rapid response towards change in concentration of H plus ions. And here, this electrode is resistant to oxidizing and reducing agent. You can any type of solution in electrochemical reactions, this electrode is resistant towards oxidizing and reducing agents. So dissolved in glass colloids, salts, etc. So third advantage is when you use lithia glass, use lithia silica glasses, so then it can be used entire pH ranges. Then can be used, the electrode can be used entire pH ranges. That means you can use it from 0 pH to 14 pH values. So these are the advantages. Now let's discuss the disadvantages of glass electrode. So here it is extremely fragile because it contains a thin bulb. So minute observations on the surface of the tip can damage the electrode. Now it can be used with a simple potentiometer. So because high resistance, so it cannot be used with a simple potentiometer because it's high resistance. So friends, these are the disadvantages of glass electrodes, and this is the class about so the electrodes we have in our syllabus. So friends, in semester exams, so they are going to ask a question about these electrodes. So one is a hydrogen electrode. First one is a hydrogen electrode. Second one, calomel electrode. Third one, glass electrode. These three are very, very important for the semester examination purpose. So friends,